Hi guys, welcome to the Modern Noob. This morning is rough on the Modern Noob. Having won only one game in three matches. But that's why we practice. It's time for one of the better decks. Actually, is it the best deck? No, yeah, Time Walk lost, so this might be now. Yeah, it is the best deck. With 78% match wins. It's Gruul Blood Moon. So I have to go back now and look at your comments to the latest video to make sure I don't miss anything. Changes, etc. I'm still wondering about the Deathrite Shamans here, but I'm not wondering as much as I'm doing in the Mono Black Infect deck. Modern Noob. White Weenie, Mono Black Infect, Gruul Blood Moon. Okay, here's the latest video. Let's see what you're saying. No, nobody's saying anything. So I guess we're sticking with this list so far. If you have any opinions about the list, if you have any changes, anything you want to see, please tell me what to cut. I'm starting to get the decent sideboard plan going. It looks like this. And my current record with the deck then is 7-2. So this is the 10th match with the deck. And it's definitely one of my favorites here. What I've done is I've taken a basic Gruul aggro list and added main deck Blood Moons. Because I'm in love with main deck Blood Moons since they allowed me to took down my Nationals. And won me entry to the World Championships at the time. But I've told that story about a million times, so I won't tell it again. But since then, I'm in love with Blood Moons. Alex complained about the Goblin list that I included four Blood Moons instead of three. And he's probably right. Amarok 666 steps out up to the challenge, or is one who wants to beat up on the poor modern noob who is just losing all the time. We want to play first. We can get... Well, I guess we're keeping this. And we are getting a Stomping Ground. We are paying. And we need to play a Deathrite Shaman here. Right, to get something going. For mana, and then we can play Curdapes and Goblin Guides next turn. But I think playing the Deathrite Shaman there is the better choice. Something black! That's interesting. So we take a red mana. And a red mana, play the Burning Tree Shaman. And the Flint of Boar. Okay, so now the Deathrite Shaman has no mana. Can't generate mana. I fear his blackness. Child of Night. I don't like a lifelinker, especially one that can block the Burning Tree Shaman. And as I said before in the Modern Noob, playing against rogue decks is helpful because it teaches you something about your deck. And I'm now gonna take a ton of damage to get rid of this guy. And smack so much face. Gave him a land. It's a shame. Hope he doesn't have mutilate. Actually, I'm in a great danger of overcommitting here. Mr. Nighthawk is of course a much better target for this member. And Searing Blazes. He's thinking about something. I'm thinking about how unable I will be to attack unless I draw one of my 8 removal spells, of which I've used one already. I have main deck dismembers just for Deceiver Exarchs and Tarmogoyfs. I hope he's not quitting on me. This does not look good. Tournament practice room. Filled with gentlemen and geniuses. Okay, so what do we do then? Start another match, maybe? Let's wait till 25. And then we start another. Okay, he conceded and left. Thanks for wasting my time, jerk. And let's play again. Okay, we try again. Now it's Poochison. I don't want to mulligan. Poochison, who is deploying a Treat of Willage on us. So what do we want to do here? We want to deploy an Experiment 1. And then we want to evolve him twice with Burning Tree Curdape next turn. Oh, I smell Jund. Well, then Burning Tree Curdape is out of the question, so maybe we should go. Burning Tree Goblin Guide or Scavenging Ooze? Not sure. Scavenging Ooze seems to be the most efficient way to use the mana. But then of course that happens. Mr. Goyf, not unexpected. Mountain, Goblin Guide, Curdape, swing for 4. Ugh. Have I played Jund before? No, I have not. Do I have a sideboard plan? Not really. Kitchen things! That's irritating. So we'll just trample hell over them, right? Well, Dark Confidant we can make worthless. Oh, he doesn't have the mana to play Lily. Ugh. Yeah, okay, what do I do now? Not much. At least he can't use the scavenging ooze. Maybe I should have saved that for the Searing Blaze, right? I should have. Damn it! I'm not sure about Dark Confidant there. That could become a real problem for him. So I am bolting the Scavenging Ooze and attacking with everything. A mountain. If he keeps his Dark Confidant around here, he will have problems. And he doesn't. So what can he play now, really? Just bolts, pretty much. Deathrite Shamans. Blood Moon turns out to be pretty good. So we're bringing in Blood Moon, Searing Blaze. They say that Jan needs their graveyard. But bringing in three ley lines seems extremely stupid. Would you do that? What do we now take out? This is super hard. I don't want to take out anything. Maybe we actually are taking out the Burning Tree Emissaries. And the reason behind that is that Jund is fast enough to defend itself. And then we're just playing bears. And two Goblin Guides. That might be insane. No! Why? Damn it. Okay, let's see if we can find him and block him. Am I doing something wrong to people? Okay, let's check the battle list. There is USB dudes. I have him on Pauper only. So we just have to play again. Can count it as a win. Okay, we try again. This is not pointless. We do get some practice with the deck. Maybe he's quitting immediately. No, he's here. He even says good luck. So, experiment one into Burning Tree, Scavenging Ooze, Blood Moon. If I find the mana. I don't want to mulligan. Is he scared to be on film? Maybe. But here is experiment one. Just in time for his bolt. The basic forest is pretty good here. So, I'm sensing... Splinter Twin. No Flint of Boar. Ah, the Scavenging Ooze. But Splinter Twin plays Blood Moon, so that won't help. I do have Combusts for him, though. I don't think the Blood Moon will be much easier. Oh god, he's slow. I fear he might be quitting on me too. Did he say anything else? No, he just said you have a YouTube channel, right? Mr. Snapcaster Mage. Killing the experiment one. Oh, that's okay, I guess. He still has no source of blue mana here. Okay, well, now he does. So, how about not playing the Scavenging Ooze until next turn, so I can grow it twice out of range of a lightning bolt. I think that's the way to do it. Uh-oh, it's Splinter Twin and I'm dead. Because I don't have any defense. Except I could actually kill a Pestermite if it was played on my turn. Well, obviously Blood Moons are coming out against Twin. Will it be my fourth straight loss today? Please no Exarch. Exarch is death. It's an Exarch. And it's just death. No combo. Did I have a way? I had a way to protect me. That was stupid. I should have done it in my turn. Okay, I'm attacking with the burning tree. Gonna gore clan it and a bolt will be really bad again. Do I still gore clan it? Probably not. I didn't play that before combat because I wanted to get through the Exarch. He will use the lighthouse now. No, he will snapcaster into a bolt. Which is never bad. We can of course Searing Blaze snapcast mage in return, but that the damage has already happened. Do I now cast the Blood Moon just to get rid of his lighthouse? Maybe I do, actually. Okay, no lifetimes for you, sir. Boomerang. I'm so dead as soon as he finds something. He only has one blue mana now, so that might actually be relevant. Cause here's a card that costs two blue mana. Charge! Maybe we just want to play the Gore Clan Rampage here. Instead of doing 4 damage at one, just once. I think we want to play him. What's happening now? This is not good. Okay, so we do play him. And then we are open for all your shenanigans. Maybe he thought I had like something to counter the Splinter Twin, but and waited for me to tap out. But I'm gambling on the fact that he doesn't have it. But I was lethal next turn anyway, wasn't I? Was I? No, it was still 4 damage. Mr. Pestermite. Oh, can't use the Scalding Tarn, of course. So you'll block the Curd Ape now and then die next turn unless he has something. Snap Custom Mages in Splinter Twin seems pretty good. Another stupid Pestomite. He's getting way too much time here to find his combo. Wow. Killing off an Exarch here is probably good because his power now is up to 4, so he could block the Rampager. And if he blocks me with Pestomite as well, then I can do 1 damage to the Pestomite. Oh, you can't do that anymore, right? So, yeah, I can. I do like this. And then I bolt Exarch. And then I will feel really stupid when I draw another bolt. So I'm saving this land in my hand for the Searing Blazes. But I don't think Searing Blaze is very efficient against him. Is Pithing Needle useful against him? Pithing Needle for what then? For Kikiiki? It's just 2 Kikiks in some lists. Maybe for Deceiver Exarch? No, that doesn't work. Oh, it does, because the Splinter Twin thing, but he can still work with Kikiki. Pithing Needle seems pretty subpar. What a nutrition battle! Will he find his combo here? Oh yes he will, at 1 life! So what do I do? Do I want the Domris actually? If I take out Searing Blaze and the Blood Moons, bring in the Combust and the Domris. I kind of like it. I am selling my Domris soon. And I don't think they're really super necessary in the sideboard here. Is this the only deck they are in? In the modern noob? Maybe. I want to play first. I have to mulligan this. I am keeping this. So we are playing experiment 1. And then pretty much nothing forever. We have to draw a land to get to Domri, but once we do that, he will have a hard time Another Domri. Well, now we really need a mana. We do have the Combust for protection here, so that will help. Goblin Guide joins the fray. Hey, Vol Trigger. Uh-oh. Oh, now you provoked him. See what you did, stupid experiment. Pestamite. Okay, so I'm not gonna tap out too much. But he misses a land drop. And giving him the land drop here is... feels rough. But I didn't this time. He dies. And Domri Raid is here. See what we... yeah. Let's reveal that thing. So, Domri's ultimate. That's pretty fun. Let's go get it. As soon as he gets his mana here... Oh, he didn't. Wow. Okay, so we Domri! Sucks to be Domri. We are getting a stomping ground. No, we are getting a mountain, maybe? Okay, we can't get a mountain with that thing. That was unnecessary damage, wasn't it? And then we play Scavenging Ooze. Three rounds to the Domri ultimate. But we have nothing to eat. We have the experiment one. We have the Goblin Guide. So I think we're eating, right? And risking the lightning bolt. And now he has to bolt it then, because I will just not do it again. Wait, does that work? Yeah, it works if I do it while I'm attacking, okay. Let's try that. So here I am eating the Goblin Guide. But now I can't do it because I'm opening myself up to the combo. Yeah, I have to keep two mana open. No, but he's tapping out now, so... there's Snapcaster Mage. He brings back the Bolt. Okay, so now I can do it. Oh, that's a bit painful. We should fight him, right? But we were too greedy. Six. Should have fought him. Bolt. Well, That's pretty good, isn't it? So we just have bolt combust here. A boomerang? No. Exarch. Damn it. Yeah, he's tapped. We are playing Flinthoof Boar. And we are ready with the combust. We gotta start fighting, right? So get rid of his dudes. Oh, he has a Pestermite too that we have seen. So I'm sure that will be used now, but we can bolt that. And keep the board free from game-winning creatures. One dude to eat. The Goreclan Rampager. Which I think we will do. Steamwent is coming into play. I can see that Pestermite coming from a mile away. Target creature you control fights another target creature, so you fight. We go to attack, the Pestermite appears. And we bolt it. Attack with the Flinthoof Boar. And play a Curdive. And we now have two people to eat. And combust ready and willing. How will I ever be able to sell my Domris? What the hell? He's not white or blue, so he doesn't matter. Does he? So let's have dinner. So we fight, maybe? You are fighting Spellskite. I don't think Spellskite will get out of that easily. And then we just attack. And the Goreclan Rampager is gonna be enough here. Right. Yay. Do I like this sideboard plan? It would be nice to Searing Blaze a Snapcaster, but I don't think that's the key. I'm pretty pleased with the sideboard plan, actually. So let's see if we can bring home a victory today. Otherwise, I will. Damn it, I will keep playing. This is a rotten hand. Stomping ground. I'm going with experiment one. Can you see the lightning bolt coming for my experiment one? I can see the lightning bolt coming to kill him now. This is just an experiment. Will he be dead? Oh, gave him a land. Sucks. Dr. Snapcaster. To stop the experiment. And Goblin Guide feels bad again. And now I won't be able to do anything because I will have to have Combust Mana open. Okay, now I don't have to have Combust Mana open because he can't cast a tapped dude, an untapped dude this turn. So let's try to kill him with Goblin Guides. But we'll probably just end up giving him a ton of lands. Oh, Lightning Bolt. How convenient. At least now we have the Combust. I am getting a stomping ground here. Should have gotten a Blood Crypt, right? Mr. Another land. He will never block here. He has run into so many Rampagers. Yeah, he knew it. Is there no way for him to survive the Combust? I don't know, why didn't I play the Curdip? This is actually 12 damage. But I doubt I will be able to do it. Do I attack here? Well, I can still trample and have Combust Mana open. Oh. And I don't need to counter both of them. So I will bolt the Pestermite here. Well, I'm really relying heavily on this combust. So now I have to kill it, right? And then Kukuki has nothing to copy. And now I can go for the kill, unless... Wow, this suddenly became very complicated. Well, if I cast one and let it resolve... No, I can kill him here, right? Yay, I won! Thanks, Virtuosos, for being a good sport and not quitting like the other guys. That was good practice. And this deck wins again. And I am 8-2 with the deck. And that's pretty impressive considering that I am 2-6 with other decks in the modern noob, so this seems to be a pretty good fit for me. Thank you for watching.